So my name is Vinay Kumar. I am Cherial painting artist. Cherial painting is a traditional art of Telangana region. So basically this art was started during 13th century when the Vijayanagara kingdom they ruling this southern part. So our art was started on ceilings of temples, walls of lot of chariots of different temples. So during that time we had done lot of Hindu mythological stories of Ramayanam, Mahabharatam, Krishna Lilalu, Shiva Puranam, like this, which all depicts our Hindu mythological stories. So later when 15th century when the Vijayanagara kingdom was defeated, so one of my forefathers, they traveled to this Telangana part. So from 15th century, actually there are some oral stories going here when my forefathers came here. So for those oral stories, we have started doing the visual language for that oral stories, just like an art form. So these stories are depicts the community based stories. So in this community based stories means all mythological stories also involves, but the majorly these all stories will depict the importance of the communities actually. So how the community have started and how was the for each and every community there will be king and queen, and there will be the, just like it's a theater arts, so like that the story will continue from starting from Lord Ganesha to and the end, the each community have their special goddesses. So like that each and every story will start from Lord Ganesha and the story will starts like that. These are 7 to 8 community stories are there. So from like 1550s like that the stories have started on the cloth actually. So before that these all paintings were done on temple ceilings and walls of temples. So later from 1550s like that our art was translated to cloth actually. So like that from that 1550s to till 19th century there was lot of exposure for our art, because there was no cinema theaters during that time. So this is the art which entertains the people and to educate also. In olden days we don't have any education system in remote areas, so this art was to display in the center of village and to entertain the people who are sitting in front of the painting, and to educate also. Each character have a importance to explain something for the viewer. So like that till the photography was invented there was lot of exposure for our art, but when the printing media and photography started, so slowly the importance of our art was came down, because the cinemas have attracted people. So like that it was came till the 19th century. So but our area in Telangana part, this area ruled by the Nizams actually. So during the Nizams time my forefathers done paintings on the their Falaknama and Chaumala palaces, like floral designing work also. So basically we are Chitrakars. Chitra means painting, kar means the person who do the work. Our community is Chitrakar community. But while doing the paintings in Nizam palaces, in the Urdu time, Urdu term, they call it as a Nakshi. Nakshi means fine line actually in Urdu term. So by seeing our fine floral designing work in their palaces, they have translated our Chitrakars to Nakashi community. So by them our community became as a Nakashi community, and our paintings also called as a Nakashi paintings also, because of we do in this Deccan plateau. So the Nizams translated our community as Nakashi also. So like that our paintings came till 19th century. And so and the artisans who was doing this painting, everyone left this art because of there is no source of income while 19th century is like that. So only my grandfather Venkat Ramaya, he is the last person who continued this work. And because he don't know any other work to go, and he full-fledgedly was in this work only. Only because of him now presently we are continuing this art. So he is the last person who continued, and he teached my father D. Vaikundam Nakash. So like that our art was came now also it's continuing. And the main reason is till 1978, till 1980, this art was done only for the storytellers, not for any private people who wants to keep in their houses just like a decorative piece. Like commercial use, our paintings were not done. Only for the storytellers, narrating purpose only we had done the paintings. So that is the reason there is only little scope of paintings orders for us. But in 1980, our state government of handicraft department, they have seen our work and they gave some ideas to do small scale paintings like 3 feet by 5 feet, like which easily can keep hang for the walls. Before that, our paintings were size of 3 feet width by 50 feet length, 60 feet, like 40, depends on the story. Mahabharatam is a 60 feet length, it's a big scroll, so like that. So from 1980s, from last 40 years, my father, he had done small scale paintings and he started, and before that also we had not gone for any exhibitions also. So from 1980 only, my father came out from our village area. So during that, the handicraft department officer, he came to our village area. So this art was doing, my father and my grandfather, they were in Cherial village. So the officer came and seen our work and he said that they promoted it as a Cherial village name only. So that's why our painting name now it's called as a, it's registered as Cherial painting only. Because of they published from the handicraft department, they promoted our art as a Cherial painting. So presently it's well known for all is Cherial painting only. So like that. And from last 40 years my father traveled all over India and some other countries also to demonstrate our paintings, to exhibit, to get awareness about our art to the people who don't know. So like that it's continuing. And as I finished plus two, I went to the arts college only, from JNTU Fine Arts College in Hyderabad. I have learned my academics in fine arts, in different mediums of which I do presently, which I am experimenting with different mediums to take my art in different mediums also, because generally we do only with the natural watercolors on the khadi cloth. So presently I am doing with the acrylic colors, like that. I am experimenting a lot with my paintings now. Actually, when I was in schooling, we used to stay in Cherial village. It's around 120 kilometers far from Hyderabad. So when I was in schooling, I used to go school and I used to come. And during the evening time, I was much interested to play with colors actually. So when I was in 6th standard, like that, by seeing my interest, my father gave some cloth to fill. While he had done the sketch part, he gave me some colors and to fill the background colors, like border colors. So I was doing, helping my father, like from 6th standard, filling the colors like that. So in village when we was there, lot of people from Hyderabad, from Delhi, to the scholars, researchers, the clients, they used to come to our village. And we don't know that much importance of art, but the people who are coming from different places to our home, and they was much excited to see our art. They were happy that we are continuing our legacy. So slowly my father used to explain me about the importance of our art, how was my art was useful for the people, the story narrating, and the it's a, first of all, it's education for the illiterates in the remote areas, our paintings. So I have much interested to continue our art. So after my 10th and my plus 2, I was much eagerly want to learn our art itself, because all my friends and they went for the engineering degree colleges. As it's a, the roots of mine is the painting only, all colors, art is my roots. So I went to fine arts college to learn and to get some new mediums, to new how the fine arts college, how they explain. Just I learned the techniques of different mediums. So but as I learned different techniques, all I want to implement to my art itself. I don't want to go for any other contemporary modern arts. just I want to take my art in a modern level. It easily means it should be for this contemporary world, my art should be displayed for the different contemporary concepts or anything. If I take, I have to translate my art to that actually. So that's why I was much eagerly, I went for the arts college only. Then I learned, I am continuing my art itself present now also. Influence means majorly when I was seeing my father's work, and when my father is explaining to me about the importance of our art, because the storytellers generally, the storytellers used to come to our home. So they came, after coming to our home, they used to stay in my home only for 1 week, because when they commission a painting to us, the storytellers, they used to stay in my home, and by orally they used to say the story, like all Mahabharatam story, like it says 3 feet width by 60 feet length. Orally they used to say story to my father, and by imagining all characters, my father used to draw with his free hands only, that much big scroll. So by seeing my father's how much he has experience, he very freely used to do the all sketch of total story. So by seeing my father's work and by knowing the history of our art, I was much influenced that I should not leave this art. Because in olden days the income source is gone, that's why a lot of artisans left my art. But present, if we do good marketing, or if people get good awareness about our art, we can stay in this art field only. So that is the reason I studied, and first I have learned all the history and importance of art from my father. So majorly that influenced me a lot, ma'am.